Hello, everyone. Welcome. This is the XoneBros. It's 2016, and we are back.
We're back, baby.
Back, baby. New year.
Back in the saddle.
New year, same show.
No change whatsoever.
No change.
Just a number six at the end of the yeah. numbers instead of a five.
This is podcast number 92. That's right, 92. As always, I am joined by the bros, the XoneBros. First and foremost, he is the man...
Did you
at
not
the
do
end of the table.
Did you not do an intro?
I didn't make any intros today.
You're busy. Sorry. I get it. That's okay. That's me. I'm the guy at the end of the table, everybody. Good to be here.
This is Mr. McSpicy, Mark Haywood.
Yay.
What one thing that you did over Christmas that you really liked? Go.
I went to San Diego.
Whoa. Very nice. Any cool stories? Fun happenings?
Oh, I went to the zoo. It was awesome.
Oh, the San Diego Zoo is really good.
It makes our zoo look
oh,
like
yeah.
it's dumb.
When I first moved here, I went to the zoo here, and I was like, this sucks.
Yeah.
Because whenever you went on field trips as kids, that was the zoo you went to. The San Diego Zoo.
Yeah, it was
really
I've
been
fun.
There like six, seven times.
Went to the beach, of course. It was fun. No, I had a good time.
Oh, very nice.
Me and the lady went out there and visited my brother who lives there. So.
Oh, very nice.
Good times.
Cool place.
Did that fulfill your question?
That does. Next, it's the man with never anything to say. It's Jordan the man, Jordan Paskett.
Hello.
Hi, Jordan. One thing that you did over break that's memorable.
I played games.
Oh. Did you really?
Yeah.
What game?
A little bit.
What game did you play the most? Or did you try anything new? Boom. That's a question.
Oh, curveball.
No, see, that wasn't over Christmas. just Fallout and Halo.
Cool beans. Cool beans. Last but not least, I am X1. We're the X1 bros. One thing that I did over Christmas break?
Yeah, that's what I just asked you.
I don't know. Dang, why don't I think of an answer for my own question?
David has had a very busy couple weeks.
I have. I'm moving in... just over a week, actually, into this guy's house,
mm-hmm.
Jordan's house.
Yeah.
He probably hates me because he has to, like, move stuff out of his basement so I can live there because we're building a new house.
Yeah, congrats.
Yes.
This is the last time you will see this room.
This is the last time that we will be in here. Next week, we'll keep it a surprise. We'll tease it. It will be unlike anything you've ever seen before in your entire life. That much I could say.
Wow.
Yeah. It's going to blow your mind. Blow it right up. It is 2016. It is a new year. It also, we got 2 weeks off. This was the longest break we took. We've missed you guys. Missed everyone out there.
Yeah.
Missed playing games. I kind of took a break from gaming. I'm not going
to
lie.
Hey, I did too, actually.
Yeah.
Except I have some core PC games I stick to.
Sure.
But outside of that, no.
Towards the end of this break, I started picking them back up and playing again, but there was good, like, right around Christmas there.
We're, like, on the same cycle,
man. I did nothing. Like, I literally... Oh, I'll tell you what I did. I watched every single Game of Thrones. did the HBO Go 30-day free trial, and me and my wife watched all the Game of Thrones in the span of 3 days.
Wow.
Yeah, it's 5 seasons, 10 episodes per season, 1 hour shows. We literally did nothing those 3 days.
That's...
Like, I don't think some of those days I even went outside.
That's a good time.
Yeah.
That's like... I mean, me and my wife went to San Diego.
Sure.
We actually drove there, which is a lot of driving.
Sure.
We could have watched that.
You could
have.
And
stayed at home in pajamas.
You could... And that's what we did for 3 days.
That's pretty good. That's a good time.
It was a really good time. and we also missed McSpicy's birthday. Happy birthday,
yeah.
Mr.
Oh,
McSpicy.
Happy birthday.
Thanks, guys.
And we have a gift for you, actually.
Ooh! Yeah.
Here it comes.
Ready for this? Boom! That's right. For those of you listening, we got him a TIE Defender from the Star Wars X-Wing
Miniatures
game.
That is awesome.
For those of you who are newer to the community, we are way into the Star Wars X-Wings. We play those quite frequently. And this is an addition to add to McSpicy's arsenal.
Collection.
Wow, that sucker looks sweet.
There you go. So happy birthday, pal.
Thanks, guys.
Belated. We were waiting for the show, so it's
well
belated.
Oh, no, thank you. Wow.
You want to hear what your original present was?
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
We actually...
Walmart ran out of it.
Yeah, freaking Walmart.
Yeah.
They got me again. Anyway, actually, I appreciate Walmart. and what they do for me.
For you, for cheap prices?
Yeah.
The 3 cents lower than anywhere else?
Yeah. So we saw it. They had cardboard cutouts of the new Star Wars characters, like BB-8.
Yeah.
They were like
life-size. Yeah, life-size cardboard.
They were $30, so me and Dave were going to split it, you know, 15 each and get a huge big one. And I know you have a crush on Rey.
Oh, yep. I do.
So they had a huge one of Rey with her staff.
But she's gone.
Yeah. Oh. I went there yesterday to pick it up.
How do you know I have a crush on Rey? Did my wife tell you?
No, you told me.
I did? Okay. Yeah.
Completely she's sold out. She's a cutie. All of them. If they didn't have Rey, I was going to get you like BB-8 or something, but did not have any. Completely sold out.
That's
two Walmarts.
I wouldn't know where to put that.
That's the point.
That's awesome that is.
In your bedroom.
Yeah. On your side of the bed.
Ray stays here. Yeah. Okay.
This is Ray's spot. And with that, let's get this show on the road. Jordan, what is happening in the world that is Xbox One this week? / past weeks, but mostly this week.
Yeah. Well, not much.
Yeah. It's been really slow.
Everybody's taking the 2 weeks off, which is
good. It's the new year.
But let's start the new year with new hardware.
Oh, yes.
I love it when you talk dirty. Yeah.
So, Microsoft announced this January 5th. We have two new bundles, Xbox One bundles. The first one is the Tom Clancy Rainbow Six bundle. It comes with a terabyte hard drive, and it comes with Rainbow Six Siege, Rainbow Six Vegas, and Rainbow Six Vegas 2, which are backward compatible, so you can get playing those right away.
Very nice.
Cool.
Very cool. Very cool. The second bundle is a 500-gigabyte hard drive with a pick-your-own game. And the choices of games are Forza 6, Rise of the Tomb Raider, Gears of War Ultimate Edition, and Rare Replay. They call that one the Name Your Game bundle.
You only get to choose one of those games?
Only one of them, yeah.
Oh.
I mean, those are good games.
But it is cheaper because it's a 500 hard drive and, you know.
So, I would go with Forza 6. How can... I don't know if I like that. Because Rare Replay was always only a $30 game. Forza's a $60 game.
Well, I know. I mean, that's if you're talking dollars to cents. But if you're choosing, which one are you going to play more?
Forza.
I get it, like, value-wise. Yeah. So Forza, so that's what you would...
That's what I would
pick.
I mean,
it's your
prerogative.
True.
Okay. I take it back. It's good. It gives you options.
Yeah.
More freedom.
I mean, those are pretty good games.
Those are all really good games.
Yeah.
Okay, never mind. I take it back.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. Back to you, Jordan.
So, if you're interested, go check those out. Very cool bundles.
Elige uno. I'm reading the Spanish translation there.
Yeah. What?
Elige uno.
Oh. Okay.
Nice.
Yeah, there you
good job.
January.
Bien hecho.
Gracias.
January has Xbox new games with gold for Xbox One M and Xbox 360, but with Xbox backward compatibility, we have all four of them. So the four games we get this month, the first one is Killer Instinct Season 1.
I already downloaded that one.
Yeah, that one's available from January 1st to the 31st. The second Xbox One game is...
Heroes or Zeros?
Zeros. Z-Heroes. Nice. That one's going to be available January 16th to February 15th. And the two 360 games that we get because of backwards compatibility are going to be Dirt Showdown, which Dirt's a fun racing game, like a rally car racing game, and Deus Ex Human Revolution.
I cannot wait for that one. I will go back and play that one.
Yeah, so if you want those two Xbox 360 games on your Xbox One, just log into Xbox.com and click download, and they'll automatically show up.
You don't even need to do it on .com. You can just do it through the Xbox.
Are you sure?
Can't you?
Last time I wasn't able to.
Oh, maybe not then.
Xbox.com? Wait, what?
To get the 360 free games of the month.
I've done it through Xbox.com.
Yeah. I don't think you can do it through the Xbox.
I haven't done it
on the Xbox One. I've just been in the.
I've only done it online.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. Dang. Okay.
You probably can. I just haven't tried because I've been doing it online every month.
Oh, okay.
You know, since they announced the backward.
Never mind then.
So,
I know not whereof I speak.
Anyway, those are the games with gold for January, available for pre-order and digital download on the Xbox One. We have APID,
or
AIPD.
Yeah,
I call it APID.
That sounds right.
Top-down co-op twin-stick shooter.
Ooh.
With crazy visual styles that homage an 80s neon.
Is it couch or is it Xbox Live co-op?
I don't know.
I would like to if it's a. That would be a fun
AIPD. One. What does that stand for? I don't know.
APID.
It stands for APID.
Okay.
It runs on the Unreal 4 engine. Very cool.
It does. It combines a slamming soundtrack and overwhelming sound effects.
All right, I'm going to sneak over to your computer because mine just broke.
Oh,
so
cool.
I'm counting over. All right, Jordan. Here I come.
Oh, we have Marvel Lego leg for the law. Marvel Lego Adventure Avengers.
Lego Marvel Avengers.
Lego Marvel Avengers. Now available also for the digital preload. Preload and download. Then we have
good game.
This War of Mine.
This is a great game.
The Little Ones is now available for digital pre-order and pre-download, and it's a good game.
It's a I have this on PC. It's a great game.
Oh, do you really?
Yeah.
This one comes out January 29th, 2016.
Tell us a little what it's
you
about.
You would like this.
I've never heard this game. What's it about? And so, I can't, Jordan, like, send me all the news, but it's all discombobulated. So
David, you especially liking this game. Okay. So it's very slow paced. It's a much slower paced game. It takes place, I think it's in Russia where it takes place. I can't be certain what country.
Yeah, it looks like Russia.
Oh.
But it's a civil, like, there's like a civil revolutionary war.
It's like
war.
A side scroller, but very artistic, like very dark looking with lots of light effects.
Dark. And you are in a house, and you have to protect your house, and you have to, it's like a survival game.
Sure.
You have to have someone, like, protect your house, and you have to go find food. Because it takes place in a time where food is scarce and people at that time were trying to survive, and so people will come and steal your stuff. You would go into another house. You would send a guy in while someone's protecting your house kind of thing. It's more – it's very sneaky. It's very
strategic.
Strategic, and it's very – it's slower, but it's very intense. And cool. It's very – like it's sad.
Because you're playing the children, are you not?
No.
Oh,
no, it's not children.
Oh, I thought you were playing the children for some reason.
No, but it's very – it's a very good game. I really like this game.
Cool.
Nice.
Anyone know the price on that? No?
You can check it if you click that green link right there.
Going for it right now. $29.99. Perhaps I will.
A game I consistently think about, now available for digital pre-order and pre-download, Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4.
How can you pronounce that and you can't pronounce Lego Marvel Avengers?
I watch a lot of anime. These words are familiar.
Say that again. I can't even.
Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4.
Whoa, man. Yeah. You just blew my mind.
Yeah, yeah. Bienecho.
That one's coming out February 9th and is going to be available at 12:01 Eastern Time. So check that out. Oh, a fancy one. The Division is now available for pre-order.
Oh, baby.
Oh, pre-download, it's pre-order.
Yeah.
Woohoo.
Now, I want to know if I still pre-order it, am I still guaranteed access to the alpha?
You are guaranteed
the alpha,
closed beta access.
But the closed beta is not coming out. I mean, I want right now.
You want right now.
Yeah.
I don't
know. Is the alpha still going on? I haven't looked.
I don't know.
I don't think it is.
I don't think so.
Yeah,
but
it was only like a week in December.
When does the Division release?
I
got it. 3/8, March 8th.
Yeah.
So that's not so far away. That one.
Well, if it releases, then there's. I mean,
yeah, it's
they pushed back already. If they're not.
But if you're able to pre-order it now,
the closed beta was pushed back.
I'm pretty sure that date is set in stone.
Yeah.
But, or at least this summer, anyway, because they had to push back the closed beta because they weren't quite ready. But.
Well,
I think that's probably the most exciting game you can pre-order at the moment.
What about Ultimate Ninja Shippuden? Four.
Yeah,
that's for
Naruto,
me. For me, Division
Naruto
is
Shippuden Ultimate Ninja. Ninja Four.
I mean, if that's what you like, then that probably is the most exciting game for you right now. But
all right, these games are all available. We got Hyper Void, just a cool name.
That is a cool name.
Beatsplosion.
Beats. Who does not like Beatsplosion?
For the Kinect, it looks like a ninja dancing game.
This
could actually go with the Naruto.
This could be...
You can play this to warm up and then play Naruto.
This really could be a workout game for you.
Yeah,
really.
It looks like
nice little cardio game going on.
So, very cool. That is now available for Xbox One and Kinect.
In fact, it says,
for Kinect.
Daily use may result in getting seriously fit. You move to the beat of the music, you punch your way through quarks and
neotrinos. It's like, you remember that scene where he's kickbox dancing in Hot Rod?
Like Taibo.
That's like what it is.
It's like a Taibo, but... to rhythm of the music.
We also have
Taibo is.
Well, but it's showing you how to have rhythm.
Okay. Are you talking about like in the park, like Tai Chi stuff?
No. What was I talking about?
I don't know.
No, I was talking about, you remember in Hot Rod when he goes to the wilderness to kickbox dance his troubles away? That's like what it is.
Okay.
Anyway, we also have G-Prime Into the Rain, which looks very cool. That's
what
available
is G-Prime? Ooh, this looks like some kind of space
thing. Yeah, it is. It is a
Wow. There's been a lot of these. This is like the next big genre, yeah. I think. Space simulator, space warfare. It's making a big comeback right now. You got really Elite cool. Dangerous. You got Star Citizen coming out, which is huge. You just had the game drop right before Christmas on the Xbox One. I forget what it's called, but it's basically a dumbed-down version of Elite Dangerous, and it's in third person. Mm-hmm. It's a lot more focused on fighting. Now you have G Prime. Yeah. Like, I think this is a genre. I love these
Into
games.
The Rain. Very cool. Also, Minecraft Story Mode Episode 4, A Block and a Hard Place, is now available for the Xbox One. Pretty cool.
A block.
I see what they did there.
Yeah. They're good. All right, Xbox 360 games. We got a new batch.
For the Xbox One, for backwards compatibility.
Yeah, we got a new batch of Xbox 360 games for the Xbox One. We got it over the break. Very cool. I'm going to go through the list. It's a pretty big list, so buckle up. We got Braid, an arcade game. We got Deus Ex, Human Revolution, which is Games with Gold. Yes. So go ahead and pick that one up. We got Doritos Crash Course.
Oh,
also
yeah.
an arcade game. I think that was like a Happy Meal game or something. You know, remember the old Burger King games?
Oh, I love those. I still have those games.
So anyway, I've actually never seen Doritos.
Sneaking was awesome. And then Pocket Racer. Pocket Racer actually was on a the great bike. Game.
Yeah.
And there's you're on these little like 50s. It was a good game. I enjoyed that game.
And then you got the other one sucked. Fable 3. Which is now on backward compatibility. One of the big ones for the month, Halo.
Fable 3, I actually already downloaded.
Yeah, I got it too. Oh, and by the way.
And I did not own that digitally.
Yeah, by the way. Well, then how did you get it?
I don't know, but it's there. I didn't own it digitally. I only had the physical copy and.
Maybe I owned it digitally.
Did you own it digitally?
Perhaps.
Yeah, which begs, or maybe not. But I think if I. Do you have Toy Soldiers? Or sorry, do you have not Toy Soldiers?
I owned Toy Soldiers.
Yeah, so
and,
did I.
And now it's on there. Yes.
No, I'm trying to think if it works with the sharing program.
Oh, I don't know.
Think of a game that I had.
Well, if you had,
did Halo Reach download onto your Xbox?
I have not checked.
Okay, you should check because Halo Reach, by the way, the other big one, Halo Reach is now available for backward compatibility. I had my disc and I threw it in and installed it.
Very nice.
A couple weeks ago.
Cool.
Iron Bridge, Canyon Lynch 2, Motocross Madness, Miss Pac-Man, Peggle, Portal, still alive, the first Portal, Spelunky, Splosion Man, Ticket to Ride, and Zuma's Revenge by PopCap.
Zuma's Revenge is a ride at Knott's Berry Farm. Montezuma's Revenge.
Yeah, I think that's... My wife loves this game.
Oh, okay.
I'll probably have to get that one. she's beaten that game.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Zuma's Revenge.
And it's like these little balls that go around the screen, and you got to shoot them as they keep getting closer and closer to you.
Cool.
And it's Montezuma. There you go, David. Back to you.
That's a name.
Back to you, Jordan.
Anyway, we got Rise of the Tomb Raider coming to the Windows Store on January 8th, coming to the PC. So for all you PC people that want Rise of the Tomb Raider coming to the Windows Store, which is pretty cool.
That is.
So we also have the Gears of War Pro League Season 1 Finals this weekend, and they're going to start Sunday, January 10th. So if you're listening to this on Monday, it already happened.
Very cool.
We'll announce the winners next week because I'm sure they'll announce them. But anyway.
Speaking of Pro League, sorry, can I go on this? I don't know if you have this in the news or not, but did you see that Activision bought MLG?
Wow.
I did not see that.
Activision purchased MLG and is jumping into the pro gaming scene. They say they really want to be the ESPN of gaming.
Cool.
In the stadium by Activision. So I
wonder if they're just going to throw like Destiny and Call of Duty in there.
Well, I just think it's really.
Well, I mean, like Activision owns
all Destiny, Call of Duty.
Basically, most of the games that you would see there.
I mean, here's a channel now that they can push their tournaments through. Mm-hmm. But beyond that, I wonder if it sounded like, just in reading it, that their business plan was literally to become, and for a huge business to do that, to become the ESPN, for a huge business to go into that thinking that, you know that they're looking at numbers that are showing that that's possible, you know?
Yeah.
So anyways, I think it's a big deal. I don't know. Maybe it's not, but I do.
Cool.
No,
that is actually really cool, yeah.
I think so.
I think it's
I don't know. I don't know much.
Activision's one of the heavy hitters out there.
Probably the heavy hitter.
Yeah.
With what they
own now. You got three of them. You got Activision, EA, and Ubisoft are your three big publishers, right?
Yeah, and Activision owns Blizzard, right?
Yeah.
And think about how many esport games Blizzard has.
Three.
I know. And those are the ones I watch.
Three, soon to be four.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. With Overwatch.
Actually, do they have three? StarCraft.
StarCraft, Heroes of the
Storm.
Storm.
Hearthstone.
And Hearthstone.
Oh, and World of Warcraft.
And then Overwatch.
And Overwatch.
World of Warcraft still, they have five.
And I'm sure Diablo somehow gets in there too.
So speaking of Activision,
I know Diablo has seasons now, but I don't think they have an esports.
So speaking of Activision jumping in and investing in gaming in this way, if you had $1 billion and you can invest in one thing in the gaming industry, where would you put your money? Where would you place your bet on? What part of the gaming industry would you put it behind? A certain game? Would you put it behind gaming like a Twitch, a streaming service? YouTube gaming, where would you put your money?
Probably streaming service.
A streaming service?
Yeah, that's, I think, ever since Amazon purchased Twitch, it's been better service.
Sure.
You know, and I think, and they obviously did that because they see the potential there.
Sure.
I think there's a lot of potential in streaming.
Mm-hmm. Well, basically, like MLG is going to be a streaming, I mean, it's a streaming.
It already
it's a
is. Type of streaming. Yeah, that's where they publish.
Yeah, I would have to say I think that is where I would put my money as well.
Yeah.
In some sort of streaming / television gaming service.
I would too.
Or Jordan and I were talking, or I would put it into a company to build the ultimate MMO.
Yeah.
Can I use this money to build my ultimate game room?
You could.
The Enterprise.
The Enterprise.
Have a big screen. Yeah. Have Worf behind me at all times.
So the Gears of War finale, season one finale is Sunday, January 10th at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Also, they're giving away a white special edition Gears of War Xbox that is probably one of the best Xboxes I've seen.
Do you have a picture
of it? It's very cool.
I want to see
No, but I'll pull it up for you later.
I really want to see it.
So, because it's cool. It's just, it's a white Xbox and it has like a black sketch of Marcus Fenix across the top.
That's cool.
So it's way cool looking. Rainbow Six Siege patch incoming for bug fixes, hit registration improvements as well on that patch. Very cool. I already get hit pretty easy, so giving the people improvements.
From my own team.
So I was playing ranked mode with Jonathan on this.
Yeah.
I think you guys are right. Ranked mode is just so much. It's a lot funner to play. I feel like you get a lot more serious people in there.
Yeah.
Makes it a lot fun. But two, I have found, I don't know what happened, but taking a little bit time off from Rainbow Six and coming back, I'm much better at that game. And I think I'm much better at that game because I wrapped my mind around not rushing in. I didn't notice. I'm like, man, the lowest I got was second place. And this is with Jonathan, you know?
Yeah.
So
you were technically first place if he wasn't playing.
If he wasn't playing, I probably would have been first place. But even with like Blitz, traditionally, I just run in with that shield.
Yeah.
Trying to blow people up and then I die.
Yeah.
But no, I was just doing really well. And I think it's a different style of play and you just have to adjust to it. Like I wasn't cognitive of this until after the fact. I was like, wow, why am I doing better? Oh, I'm not rushing in.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So that game is patience. You have to have patience in that game.
Strategy.
Yeah.
But anyway, so this update has been released on the PC versions and it's coming to the console versions next week. It's patch 1.2 and it's going to be making, like I said, the hit registration improvements.
Yeah, one of the bigger ones too is this matchmaking improvements.
Refining the quality of PvP matches with more evenly matched opponents is one of their fixes. Now, this patch doesn't fix all the huge, you know, all of the issues that, all the top issues that Siege is having, but they're still working on the other issues in the background. They're just getting, I think it's, like always, priority first.
Yeah. Right? So speaking of this game, so sure. You know how I took time off just like you took time off, and I pulled this game up. I played one match, I appeared, and got killed by my own team.
Oh, like, okay, man.
All right, I'll play again. And same thing happened again.
No.
I don't think I'm going to play this game
right now.
Like right
away at the start?
Right at the beginning.
Whoa.
Two in a row.
Dude, that's just bad luck.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is awful.
I know that they promised before the release that they were going to kind of punish people for that. Mm-hmm. But apparently it's maybe... You know, I know that my data pool isn't that big. It's only two games. But that's 100% for me, you know? So I hope that...
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah. So I was like, I think I'm going to play something else. So and then I go to Massive Chalice to start playing that game.
Oh, that game's
fun. I wasn't installed yet, so I'm like, dang it.
Oh, man. Massive Chalice will scratch that XCOM itch.
Ooh. Which, by the way, XCOM 2 comes out in February.
I did watch some XCOM 2 footage.
Woohoo, me
Do you know
too.
What else comes out in February?
Sorry. Not for Xbox. It's just PC only. Yeah. But
Far Cry Primal.
Ooh, oh, yeah. One of the games that I said in our last show that I'm most looking forward to in 2016.
It arrives next month, and there will actually be no co-op support for Far Cry Primal, only a single-player experience.
I think it was Troubadour who tweeted out, this is my Far Cry co-op game, Ark Survival. And ever since then, and I've thought about it like that, it really is. It really is. Mm. That's what Ark is.
Yeah.
I mean, a less polished Far Cry, of course, but...
Yeah.
I hope they nail the story in Far Cry, because I'm really looking forward to playing that.
Yeah, it's
they
gonna be
usually
fun
do a great job. Okay. They do pretty good.
But based on that, I'm excited.
No,
go look at the one similar to this is Blood Dragon, because, you know, go look at those trailers for Blood Dragon.
Oh, yeah, I remember those trailers when the ED3 and stuff, when they came out, they were
like
hilarious.
80s action movie. Oh, yeah. It's fantastic.
So Far Cry Primal comes out February 23rd, and no co-op, just a single-player experience. Smite is adding a new character map and Japanese
pantheon. Really cool. Yeah. Also, right now Xbox One is hosting it, but it's the
first ever
mythology mayhem.
MOBA. First ever, so history right here. First ever
history being made.
First ever MOBA tournament on a console going on right now.
It's right now on Twitch. 1.17 million is the prize.
Yes,
January 7th through January 10th.
Guys, we got to start playing Smite now that they're having.
No, 1.17 million. Let's pour hundreds and thousands of hours just to scratch the surface of a game.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. No, I was watching a little bit on Twitch. It does make me want to play. It's really cool. But they did reveal the new map. It's called Joust. Very cool.
Really?
In the sky.
Oh, that is
very
cool.
Very cool. I'm excited. I really do want to jump back into Smite. It's fun and it's free, so you really can't complain.
Yeah, you really can.
Yeah.
I mean, you can.
You can.
Makes you a douche.
Yeah.
So that makes me a douche.
Yeah. You can complain about free games? You're a douche.
That's funny. But anyway, very cool. Check out the tournament. It's actually really, really fun to watch. So
cool.
Some of the most depressing news I've heard.
No.
I saw this.
Yeah.
I saw this one.
Scalebound release date delayed until not just a couple months.
They're 2017. Like, you know what? Let's give it a year.
Yeah. It was supposed to come out this year. They took a look at the calendar and said, nah, next year. But they did say, quote, they need to delay it because...
quote, this is what we need to do. Yeah.
They need to delay it because to deliver their ambitious vision is what they said.
They don't
basically,
want to release
they don't think
game.
It will be ready.
Yeah. So well, and it's honestly, it's probably like a lot of network.
Why even announce a date nowadays? Just say we're working on this game. We'll let you know in the future when it will come out, and then when you're for sure it's ready, just sit. Then at that day, announce it.
Is this a rhetorical question?
Yeah. Well, how many games have we seen pushed back? Why not just
because
wait until you're for sure?
Okay, well, I think when they're playtesting it,
it's a different. It's different.
You know what? I'm going to lose weight tomorrow. That's when I'm going to start to lose weight. Do you see that? Do you see what I'm doing there? You know what? If I tried losing weight today, I'd probably actually lose weight. They're putting a finite number on it so they can have a goal to meet.
Oh, okay. Is this the deadline?
Yeah.
So they would work harder.
But you could have an internal deadline.
Yeah, but when the public knows.
They held you accountable?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, okay. I think it's probably their multiplayer stuff that they're working on that's probably going to take them, you know.
Yeah. I think it's just training those dragons.
Yeah, they actually bring them into the studio.
Yeah.
And they have
yeah. I mean, if you've seen behind the scenes, they have those guys taped up in black suits and they record the dragons' motions, you know?
Oh.
Yeah. It's real dragons in there that they're...
real dragons.
Yeah, real dragons. They're just training them. They've got to motion capture them to make it accurate in the game.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Makes sense.
Realism.
Kind of dangerous.
Yeah.
It is.
That's probably why they had to delay it.
Yeah.
Making video games is a dangerous business.
Yeah. Anyway, that's unfortunate. Although, I mean, I'd rather have a full, finished, awesome game than a broken game. So.
Yeah. So you're slightly disappointed.
Well, I was really looking forward to this one. This is one of my favorites for 2016.
Beats, headphones, dragons.
Yeah.
OP dragons. Like, you do, like, 10 damage.
And then you can play with your friends' dragons.
Yeah.
So, it's... Yeah. Anyway, but yeah, that's coming out 2017 now.
Well, yeah, so Ark.
I wonder what their
Ark,
Microsoft
Ark is dinosaurs. Oh, I guess we still have basically dragons.
Dragons still have, without wings.
Well, pterodactyls.
But those are like those are deformed
remember,
dragons.
Remember the very first trailer? There was a dragon.
There was a dragon. Yeah. Remember?
Yeah.
The very first trailer, right?
In the underground cave.
I wonder if that's Endgame.
I don't know.
It's got to be
the Ender Dragon.
The Ender Dragon.
but we still have Quantum Break this year, so that one hasn't been delayed yet.
But it was delayed previously.
And then one last story. I just
did you just skip over Quantum Breaks?
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay. I didn't know if there was a Quantum Break story.
No. One last story. I just got today actually just looking at it. They have 11 new minutes of gameplay for the game Perception. It's from the ex BioShock developer and ex Dead Space developer too. It's about a blind girl. Oh. Going into a house.
Oh, that's cool.
So, but very cool. I think it's a Kickstarter as well.
What's it called?
It's called Perception.
Oh.
So, and it's really cool looking.
I was gonna say, check it out. Keller's Revenge? Or...
No.
That's terrible. That was a bad joke.
Anyway, yeah, but kind of...
That was offensive.
That was... I'm sorry for all
of you. Oh, did I? I think I missed a couple. Lonely Planet is now available also. Did I go over that one?
No, you didn't.
Yeah, and then also, geez, wow, I missed a lot. I wonder what happened with my thing. Battlefield Hardline has a new cinema... Dave, why don't you just read them since you have the leftovers pulled up?
Battlefield Hardline, the new expansion...
Cinematic. Getaway.
Has a cinematic trailer. Looks really cool.
Getaway.
Looks really
That's
cool.
That's what it's called.
The new expansion adds 4 packs and has a new mode, Capture the Bag. Imagine it's like Capture the Flag. But there you go.
But with a B.
So go check out the Watch Battlefield expansion. Also, there was a ton of games on sale this week that Jordan did not go over.
Stupid email.
Go for
I pulled
it,
them all up from because I emailed them all to myself.
I've got to find it because...
we can't count on this guy. It's up to you, David.
Oh, here we go. So this week's Deals with Gold. And Spotlight sale. Did you guys pick up any games during the Christmas sales?
No.
It ended yesterday.
I actually have them all.
Wait, did it end January
7th? Sales
7th?
Don't really go well for me.
I think I did.
Did it end January 7th or January 10th?
I think it just ended this week.
Or so is it going on right Sunday? Now? I think it might end January 10th. I don't remember.
I legitimately have them all.
Oh, okay.
I think I did, and I think I'm in trouble for it.
I think I did, too. I don't remember. I remember, The second or third day in, I just bought three of them.
I went over with budget stuff with my wife, and I think I'm in trouble. I had a really fun December.
You know what's funny is
starting when I got the Elite.
You know what's funny is so I work with your wife.
No, yeah, everyone. Jordan works with my wife. Go for it.
And she sits next to me, and she was doing the budget today, and she couldn't find a game. It was funny. She was like, "Where's this game at?" And she was like looking for it in the budget. She eventually found it, but it was just funny. I was like, "Oh,
yeah, that's
Mark's
Jordan's
in
like,
trouble."
I
was in trouble.
Jordan's like texting Mark, like, "Hey man, be prepared." Anyway, yeah.
I didn't get that. What's up, man?
Yeah,
you should have gave me the heads up.
Hey, heads up! She can't find where you bought Fallout. That's what it was. She was looking for Fallout.
So this week's discounts are good through January 11th. So the next 3 or 4 days, it's Badland Game of the Year Edition, Lara Croft and Smite. Badland Game of the Year, 67% off Lara Croft and the Temple of Osiris, which is the top-down dungeon version,
cool.
Is 75% off. That one might be worth taking a look at.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and then Project Root is 50% off. I don't remember Project Root. I don't know what it is, but it's 50% off. Wait, I'm taking a look right now. Oh, Project Root. It's a space battle game. Wow. Well, that's cool. It's like the top. Remember the top down, like the Apache game where you fly in your top down, you're hitting tanks and stuff? That's what this is. That's Project Root. Looks really cool. Maybe I'll pick that up. It's 50% off. For Smite, you got the Ultimate God Pack bundle. It's 33% off. Battlefront Deluxe.
I want to buy it just because how can you not buy it with that title?
Yeah. Battlefront Deluxe and Standard. Deluxe, Standard, and Ultimate Edition are all on sale. 33% off. The Dear God is 33% off. And last but not least, Whispering Willows is 50% off. And that does it for the deals. This week's Deals with Gold, December 11th. Hit that up before it's too late.
Jordan grabbed my TIE Fighter. I would have had that
TIE Defender.
That's a TIE Defender, dude.
Sorry.
Come on.
I would have had that open, but it's like mark proof.
The packaging is, you can't steal it.
I'll try, from my seat, I'll try and look for scissors for you.
Just with visual.
Your eyes.
There's none in here.
Speaking of Star Wars.
That is so. I saw that right when I came in.
Yes.
Everyone, check this out. We have a new
podcast member.
It's BB-8. My wife got me this for Christmas.
It's so cool.
The BB-8 robot.
He rolls around.
My dogs have a blast with him because he's sound activated.
Oh, hey, BB-8.
And that's him right there.
That is so cool.
And there he goes. And he'll just roll around. He'll join you. He's my little buddy sometimes at night. I'll just hang out with him. But
go get BB-8, a drink of water with you.
One of the coolest presents of all time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With that, that's a nice transition. Let's talk about Star Wars. Gary Wells wrote in and wants to know our thoughts on Star Wars. Without giving away any spoilers, we saw it the last time you listened to us. We were about to go see it. Mick Spicy, what do you think of Star Wars, the Force Awakens?
Without any spoilers, this is hard. I love that movie so much. I saw it a couple times.
Sure.
Three or four times, I
think. Wow.
Yeah. I loved it. They basically gave me what I wanted for a long time.
Okay.
It's Star Wars.
Yeah, cool.
And it's you like the characters. I have a crush on Rey, you know. And it's how do I do this without J.J. Abrams? He was the director. He was over Star Trek as well. I really enjoyed the new Star Treks as well because he catered to the originals, like The Wrath of Khan, for example. Sure. You know, he added so many like Easter eggs for people like that are hardcore like me, or I know there's harder core people, but it just I really really enjoyed it a lot. I don't know what else to say without spoiling stuff. Because there's so many details I could tell you, but I like it.
So you really, really like it. You've still liked it enough to see it three or four times.
Yeah.
Jordan,
love that movie.
How about you?
I've only seen it twice, but it's really good.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed it. A lot of cool theories out there.
Yes. Jordan has one complaint. Express your complaint.
Oh.
No spoilers?
No spoilers with this complaint.
Okay, so I like a good bad guy. I think the bad guy either makes or breaks your movie. For example, the original Star Wars, Darth Vader.
Yeah,
greatest bad, one of the greatest bad guys. Yeah,
8 feet tall.
He choked someone and just killed him within the first 15 minutes, and you're like, whoa.
Yeah, don't mess with them. Yeah.
Very, very cool, right? And then they go and tell his origin story and pick a one. Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway, and then like Dark Knight, Joker, Heath Ledger, excellent job.
Yeah, but you're talking, that's like the best version of a bad guy.
Yeah, very good bad. Yeah, and it makes that movie. Yeah. Very good bad guys. Okay. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So... anyway, the bad guy in this starts out way up here. Like, opening scene, does some really cool stuff I've never seen before. And you're just like, whoa. His name's Kylo Ren. Everybody knows that, right?
Should we just put a moderate spoiler alert?
There's no spoiler here.
Okay.
Anyway, he's very cool. And he, later in the movie...
So when you say later in the movie, we may be getting into moderate spoilers.
No.
I'm just worried.
No spoiler.
Okay, screw it.
Later on.
Plus, this movie has... built in or raked in $1.5 billion already. I'm pretty sure you've seen it.
So. Okay, go for it.
So later in the movie, he takes off his helmet at a certain point, and when he takes off his helmet, it just...
It ruins it for him. Seeing the man behind the mask.
It just kind of like, oh, that's the guy we're afraid of? You know?
Yeah.
Well, and the thing is first of all...
Me and Jordan spent like 3 hours debating this.
Yeah.
I understand Jordan's point, and that is a complaint that's out there.
He started out like at a 10. I mean, he's still a good bad guy. Sure. I still like him. I think he was on that line of almost being a little too whiny-ish, you know what I mean? Like, I think he was on the line. He like started
never say that about me.
He started out at like a 10, like that opening scene. You're like, oh, man. And then by the end of the movie, I think he dropped down to about a 7.
For you.
For me, sure. But he's still a good bad guy, and I understand what they're trying to do, you know, character development. He wasn't quite decided if he was a bad guy or not yet, and then he made his decision and became a bad guy, you know?
Sure.
And I think in the next movie, it's going to be really Empire Strikes Back-y, where, you know, the good guys lose, which I like, you know, I like when the good guys have to actually fight to win. It's not just an easy thing. But... Like, he takes off his helmet, and it's a Pantene Pro-V commercial. You know what I mean? He's got this long
that hair to hide his ears.
Did you see his long luscious locks.
He had this, you know, long fluffy hair, and it was just it just took me out of it for a second.
I disagree. I think he did a good job.
No, I think he was a good.
Yeah, yeah. Hey,
there's nothing wrong with that.
I think you're setting up. You got to remember, when the original Star Wars, we saw the end of Darth Vader. We didn't see the beginning of Darth Vader, and when we did, it sucked. just because they did a bad job.
I
thought they did a really good job of showing that he, you know, he's still conflicted. We're at the beginning of him being a bad guy, basically.
No, I did too, and I think I did.
But I see what you're saying. He is so much cooler in that mask.
Yeah, scar him up a little. You know what I mean? Cut his hair.
He's now got a lightsaber gash over his face. Now he's gonna have a scar.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you need to make him look like a
next movie. He'll probably have a shaved head.
Yeah, see, I would appreciate that. Well, because
ears are going to be huge.
There is no bad guy in this world, good bad guy, that has fluffy long hair.
Joker.
No greasy long hair.
Oh, that's true. But see, in the future, you probably have really high technology shampoo.
I'll tell you a bad guy with a good bad guy with long hair. Thor's brother.
No, see, slick long hair. It's not fluffy.
Ugh.
It's just straight down.
He started out fluffy, and then it turned greasy.
Any mad scientist has fluffy hair.
No, they're usually bald.
Fluffy bald.
I'm going to figure out.
Partially.
Okay, it's my goal during this show to think of a bad guy that has great hair.
Okay, my take on Star Wars, I really liked it. I think a good way to describe it is that it was tastefully done. It's not like, for those of you who haven't seen it that are Star Wars fans, and you go and if you listen to all the reviews out there that are really very well, I mean, all the reviews give it high marks. It's not the greatest movie in the world. It's not the greatest Star Wars in the world. I think that it was perfectly done. It was a lot like A New Hope. Uh-huh. It's setting everything up. They didn't overdo it. Tasteful. I think it was tastefully done.
A good start to a new Star Wars.
I've seen that a lot of people complain that it was a lot like A New Hope, but it was done like that on purpose.
Yeah, I appreciated it.
Yeah, I like
it. Trying to be revolutionary in graphics like George Lucas would have made it.
Know why I like that it's like A New Hope? Because that means the second one might be like an Empire Strikes Back, and that was the best Star Wars one. Yeah.
Anyways, thank you, Gary Wells, for writing that in. If you guys want to submit questions to us every Friday, please submit questions via
good bad guy. That's what I'm saying. Good bad guy.
I'm on Google image searching, and I don't know if I should be searching this.
Anyways, every Friday you can submit questions via Facebook, or you can contact any of us on Xbox Live or Twitter, yada, yada, yada. Peter Hernandez has a question. He wants to know what you guys did during your time off. We talked about it a little bit. Jordan the Man, what did you do during the time off the last 2 weeks?
I played games.
What games go?
Okay, actually.
Me? You pointed at me.
When I take a break from games, I just go play a different console.
Okay. Good for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's how I take breaks. I bought a new phone over Christmas.
Here's what he's been playing. Yes. Are you ready for this?
I'm actually really
mad.
I've had conversations with him and him staring at his phone playing this game.
I'm actually really upset because I've been attacked like 50 times in the last 2 days. I got a new phone and it can handle games. So I still don't think, you know, phone games are the future.
Sure.
But I've been playing a lot of Clash of Clans
and a game called
Subterfuge. Really cool game. It's actually like Risk. It's very
Subterfuge I might check out.
Yeah, it's super cool. And you only have to check in like maybe once or twice a week, so it's a good little...
So over Christmas break, you started playing Clash of Clans.
Oh, yeah.
And you're addicted.
I'm very upset because I was attacked a lot.
And you're probably being beat up by 9-year-olds.
Probably.
Yeah.
That have
their parents' credit card.
Yeah, and I can't use my credit card.
No, really though, you like that game? It's a good game.
Yeah, I actually really like it.
Yeah.
I don't think there should be ClanCon. I mean, the game is so big that there was ClanCon.
That game is huge. That game pulls in. It pulls in millions of dollars a day.
Yeah, it's ridiculously popular.
Yeah,
but anyway, I do like it. I see the addiction. It's good. I like it. I also watched a lot of Netflix.
Oh, very nice. Anything unique?
I started a new show. I was telling Mark and you about it.
What
show is that? It's called Psycho Pass.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Absolutely.
Japan's version of Minority.
McSpicy, how about you? You already talked about it. You went to San Diego. Do anything else over the break? Peter Hernandez would like to know.
Peter Hernandez?
Yes.
Okay. I didn't play too many Xbox games. I don't think I turned it on for like a full couple weeks.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. My wife did. She played some Just Dance.
Oh, okay.
Because I got her that for Christmas. Because she likes to dance. Yeah.
On the Kinect?
On the Kinect, yeah.
Wow. Oh, cool.
So I'll actually try it out, Jordan. I'll let you know how I do.
Yeah.
Drox.
I like to turn it on easy.
So chat is still having a Star Wars discussion. Sorry. And Drox2X just said, nothing is better than that love banter between Anakin and Padme.
that hurt me.
Those lines were so awful.
That cracks me up.
She's intoxicating. Oh, it's so gross. Oh, no. I really just kind of took it easy over the course. I played Heroes of the Storm. I played some Hearthstone. And that's just because it's on my PC and
Your phone.
Myself, over break, I got fat. Let me tell you how I know this. My brother and I took our measurements. You know, you measure your arms, your stomach, your chest, you know, so we could start when we were weightlifting, measuring our progress, right?
Yeah.
November 2015, my stomach, which is belly button around, came in at a whopping 41 inches.
Hmm.
Not too shabby, not too great, right?
Yeah.
Want to be under the – if you're in the 30s, you're looking pretty swelled, my friend, right? As of yesterday, I am – so 41 inches. I am 43 inches. That's two inches over Christmas break. So I ate, and I ate, and I ate some more. And watching Game of Thrones sitting in your house for 10 hours a day, every day – that will do that to you.
That'll do it.
And so that's what I did. Thanks, Peter Hernandez, for that question. Adam Ratcliffe wants to know your favorite Xbox accessories. What couldn't you live without?
Accessories?
What's your favorite one?
So does smart glass count as an accessory?
Yeah.
Right now?
The headset.
That's a good one. Yeah.
What's your favorite headset? Anyone who has?
I actually just have the – I used to have the Turtle Beach, which I really like, Turtle Beach for the 360. I had two pairs. But I actually just have the standard Microsoft ones for $60 that you get at the store. They work great. They're comfortable. They work perfect. They have the mic monitoring with that adapter that you can get separately, you know?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, those are the ones I use.
I have a couple. I have the Titanfall Atlas. You know, I got that when Titanfall came out. Mm-hmm. Then I also got – they're called the X1s, right?
The XO7s.
The XO7s, yes. That's right. Those – okay, that's a cheap – headset, like you can tell it's plasticky and flimsy. Uh-huh. The cord's not very long, yada yada yada. The mic on that, it sounds fantastic, and the quality. I use that as my regular headphones, like listening to my music.
Sure,
it's cheap as all can be, but it sounds good.
Yeah,
and I don't know if that's just my model or what, but
no, the XO7s are really good. I have the XO4s. And I really like those as well. As far as accessories, I would say right now, the accessory I cannot live without is my controller, the Elite controller. It is – I can't hold a normal controller now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Yeah. So that and headsets, I think. Those are two. I could not play a game anymore. It's just not as immersive.
Yeah.
Even if you turn the volume up, it's not the same. You can't hear the little when it's right up against your ear, you know, the little stuff, the rain.
Headset.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say headset.
Headset.
Yeah, headset.
Headset.
I would agree. Headset and then a close. No, I'd say my controller first, then headset.
I mean, smart glass is really nice with, you know, conversing with people.
Sure. Thanks, Adam, for that question. Rustin Jones wants to know, how do we handle game ADD? I have tons of games that I've started and haven't finished. Do you guys like to complete and move on or jump around? And did the podcast hinder your gaming since you have to play so many so you can discuss them? Has your gaming habits changed since episode one? We've talked about this before, how we handle them. But I really like the question on has our gaming habits changed since the podcast has started. To recap, in case you haven't heard before, McSpicy, he is a OCD type of player. Once he starts a game, he completes the game 100%, immerses himself for a couple weeks, and then he's done and walks away. Mm-hmm. Jordan does a little bit of everything all at once and slowly completes them to progress. I don't know how he finds the time, but on multiple systems, mind you.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And
Clash of Clans is going to ruin your life.
Yeah.
You know that, right?
Well, I'm actually really, really mad at it right now. Because
good
for
you.
I don't think you understand. I've literally been attacked like 9 times in the last 2 days.
We're at Target yesterday, and he's like, they got me again. And you're walking around. I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
It's just so ridiculous.
It was Liam Neeson.
So Jordan is he does give him respect. He consistently plays 3 or 4 games simultaneously to completion. I'm a guy that plays a little bit of everything and never completes anything. That is me. Next shiny thing I see on the wall, yes, I'm there. And then, oh, wait, over here. I'm so easily distracted.
Yeah. I'm starting to turn into that because with my work schedule, it makes it really hard to go the distance.
Sure.
You know, so I'm starting, but my preferred method is, like you said, to beat it.
Yeah.
But I get that, and it's getting harder and harder. I have these that I have to finish.
And it's frustrating.
It's super frustrating.
Yeah, very frustrating. My life is one big frustration.
Well, right, thankfully, now we have kind of a dry patch. You got until the end of February to kind of,
yeah,
that's
before
true. The next one you buy. You know,
yeah,
what I mean?
That's so true. So Rustin wants to know: has the podcast hindered our gaming? How has it changed our gaming habits since we've started the podcast? McSpicy, has it changed your gaming habits?
Yeah, I've definitely purchased games I would have never bought before.
Sure,
just so I could say that I've played it. You know, which, like I said, my budget with my wife,
yeah,
makes it harder to get the money to do that. Mm-hmm. But no, I've played a lot. I've played a lot more because of the show, mm-hmm, for sure. There's no question. Yeah.
Yeah.
Jordan.
Same. I've played a lot more too because the show, you know, expanded.
Sure.
Also, I use it as an excuse to play.
Yeah.
I do too. That's a good call.
With my wife.
I got to play for the podcast, man.
Yeah. Yeah. And then what you got to do is you got to look depressed. You're like, dang it, I have to play this, dear. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I have to do it. I've got to sit here, and I've got to play this game till I beat it.
I know, and you act like mad. Like,
I wish, you know. But see,
I really wish I could sit down and watch Downton Abbey with you, but I have got to play Mortal
I'm
Kombat.
I'm in trouble now because my wife listened to the show. Does Sarah listen?
She'll pull up a thing every now and then.
Okay,
and
good. Hopefully,
skip around.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Because now she knows that when I sound all depressed, she knows that it's a lie.
Giving away your secrets. Anyways, great question, Russ, and it's definitely changed our habits. I think everybody has game ADD, especially at this point when if you're a gamer and you love games, the amount of games that are coming out on the Xbox One and good quality games, I think everybody's suffering from ADD. So you're not alone, Rustin. You are not alone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Major Nelson, even on the show this week on Xbox Today's show, he talked about what game he's going back to because there's just a lot to play. He's going back to Witcher, by the way.
Oh, you know, that has been on my radar for like 3 weeks now. And every time I open it up, I'm like, got to play Witcher. Then I'm like, oh, got to advance Madden. Oh, here I am in Madden. Let's throw down some Madden.
It's the game with games with dailies. That's what that's what screws up my schedule.
Yeah.
I used to be just finish this one. But now that I have these games that if I don't do it, I don't get the coins or I don't get Ashes 200 whatever credits on Rainbow Six.
Yeah.
It messes with me.
Yeah.
I have that schedule now. It's is true. Doing the games that don't have endings.
Dailies are ruining your gaming schedule. Jeremy Pedersen writes in and has an interesting question. He wants to know where each of our hard drive space is at, and do we think, where do we think everyone's hard drive space will be by the end of this gaming cycle?
Like the end of the console?
The console, yeah.
It's going to be maxed full.
You're going to have to...
You're going to have like 10
because I think I'm 36% and I have a 3 terabyte and a 1 terabyte. And I'm 36%. Or maybe 38%.
I have 20 gigs left and I have a terabyte and a half. So, because I have the 500 on the console and then a terabyte.
Yeah.
And we have the terabyte consoles.
Yeah. That's why I got the terabyte console because I wanted that upgrade. Plus, I have a 3 terabyte external hard drive and... You know, I'm one third the way there. For
they'll just come out with bigger hard drives with newer consoles, like a terabyte. The console they release, you know, next year, the year after, will probably have 2 terabytes internal hard drive. Sure. You know what I mean? That's just how they'll do
it. I have so much bandwidth though; I just delete games now.
Yeah, no, actually, I like having them on there. So I have been going. I went through and downloaded all the 360 games that pop up. And
What's nice is the 360 games thankfully aren't that huge.
Yeah, they're
so
small.
But. What's nice is the fact that it saves to your profile, so you can delete it and just go right back and boom.
No, like my games install in minutes now, so whatever. It's like, whatever.
How many hard drives do you think the average person will have by the end of this? External hard drives.
Like that they've gone through or that they have
connected that they'll have connected.
They'll just upgrade it.
Yeah, because you have 1, 2, 3, 4 USB ports? 2, 3
Although,
USB ports on the
I mean,
Xbox
once
one?
We get into like the 4 terabyte range, that's hard to fill. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Well, I'm at 3 terabytes, like you said.
And you're going to get to the point where you don't play a game anymore, so you'll just delete it.
That is true. No, that is true.
I don't think it's going to be as big of a deal as we're making it out.
Well, and then as time goes on, they'll figure out better ways to optimize and compress them. You know what I mean?
So, that's true as well. Man, all great points, guys.
Thanks, David.
Way to go. Way to go. No, I bet you I get one more external hard drive before the end. I bet you it's a big, like,
two, five terabytes.
You're getting, now you're getting huge hard drives for like $150.
Yeah, it's not even that bad.
So, anyways, but I bet you I get one more.
Yeah.
Anyways, thanks, Jeremy. I thought that was a great question. Joe Engelkins wants to know, do you think Xbox will get in the realm of virtual reality? CES was this week. There was a lot of virtual reality things that came out.
Xbox?
The price of the Oculus came out. The Oculus Rift came out. $600.
Yeah,
very disappointing. The head of Oculus was beat up quite a bit online because he said it should have been around $300, you know, might come out $300 or $400. $600. So do we think Xbox will get in the realm of virtual reality?
I would say the brand, probably. Maybe they'll give it a shot, but not this Xbox One.
I think Microsoft, being who they are already in a good position. They have the HoloLens, which they're working on in augmented reality, and then they partner with everybody. They just go, okay, Oculus Rift.
Yeah.
Sell our controller with yours and put our name on. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So Oculus Rift with Xbox One. You know what I mean?
The problem is when you look at that $600 price point, and everybody's saying the HTC Vive is everyone's favorite at CES that they played.
Mm-hmm.
It comes with a Kinect sensor and then four room sensors, and
How much is that going to?
It just works really well. And that's the thing. Everyone says the price on that is going to be at least what the Oculus
$500 at least, because you think you got the thing itself plus your four sensors.
Not only that, but you have to have a pretty ballsy computer to run that thing. So it's not like you're buying it as a separate console and I can run all my games in this. It's an add-on to an already expensive machine, at least $1,000, right, to run that bad boy.
Oh, at least.
So I don't know if we're there yet. Well, will we be there? Probably one day. But I don't know if we're there yet, and I don't know if Microsoft is willing or needs to spend all this wait until it's figured out. And then jump on board.
Mm-hmm.
You're so big, you have so
buy
much
up
money.
All DirectX again, you know, and just
and then make a console out of that.
But I think that's why I think augmented reality is much closer to being here for games like the Xbox than is virtual reality.
Yeah.
Because the minimum, 90 frames a second is the minimum. And it's going to be a 3D environment in your head, basically, rendering 90 frames a second for every single scene, every single game, to prevent motion sickness.
Yeah.
That's a ballsy computer.
Yeah.
I think it's got to be at the end of my lifetime, because traditionally I'm going to want a controller. You have to.
Yeah.
You're going to have to.
Well, I was
you're
just
not
going
to. Us, like gamers like us, are not going to want to play that.
Well, they do all have controllers, though.
Yeah. Well, that was they do like
you're talking
put
about
them
augmented
on.
Reality. Oh, okay, yeah. Sorry.
Well,
yeah.
that was my worry. I was reading. I think it was either the December or the November Game Informer, and it was all about VR, and it said the future VR is here, right? And I was worried because I think it's cool and it's great, and you know it'll be fun, but at the end of the day, my favorite thing to do is to sit down on the couch and play like arena multiplayer with a controller and the TV. You know what I mean? Like that's gaming at its pure form.
Sure.
Like, or Rainbow Six, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm just worried that everybody's like, gaming has to shift this way.
No.
You know what I mean?
No, I mean, I don't.
It won't.
Yeah, I think that you'll have, it'll be interesting.
I think it's cool.
And it's pushing
boundaries.
I want to
get one and do things and play with it, but like, I don't want it to be the only option. I want to still have my controller.
Yeah, there was a lot of outrage at the price of the Oculus Rift this last week.
Yeah, you can buy both consoles for the price of the Oculus Rift.
What's his face? Cynical Brit.
Total Biscuit.
Total Biscuit. There we go. I watched a post with him, and he said it best. He said, guys, this is what cutting-edge technology costs. Period. Cutting edge hardware. Like, that, you know, don't complain. You know?
Yeah.
So they're not trying to rip you off. They, you know, they've got they're pioneers in this area.
Well, who's complaining, I wonder?
Well, I mean, I think.
Because, like
you
said,
they made the PR mistake of saying between $300 and $400.
Because I don't know. I mean, maybe they do, but I think a lot of people don't know that it runs off your PC, and your PC needs to be huge to run that thing properly. Because it has to run at 120 frames per second so it doesn't get you sick. That was like
optimal. I think 90 is
90
the
was their thing, yeah. And, I mean, to do that alone, I mean, some games you don't have to have a super powerful PC, but most games, especially the newer ones, you do, you know.
So will Xbox, what is our, will Xbox jump into it?
I think Microsoft and Xbox will try.
I think they'll just put their name on it.
Yeah.
Like other, you know, like Xbox presents Oculus.
Just wait,
you know,
see
what
where
I mean?
The
like
chips fall. Then pick a side.
Like what they're doing with Oculus for now. They sell
if virtual reality is the future, and that looks like what it, I mean, if it gets to a point where there's no question that's what it's going to be, of course Xbox
is
going to jump in.
How do you do virtual reality on a platformer?
That's the big question with PlayStation. How is PlayStation going to do I don't think they've ever answered that question or addressed it. If the Oculus and HTC have to run on these ballsy computers, how is the PlayStation
Because they said at
going
E3,
to handle
they'll
that.
Probably they said at E3, because he made the comment, he said, and it will run off of our console.
Yeah, I mean, if it can, wow.
You can say, you know, PlayStation has the best hardware out of, you know, the three consoles that are out now, but, you know, it's not it's not that much better than what's in the Xbox. You know what I mean? It's not.
If the PlayStation was a PC, it'd be what, a $400 PC?
Well, that's what it is. It's a $400 PC. That's all consoles are. Right? The Xbox is a $400 PC.
Yeah.
Dedicated to playing games, right?
Well, no, and what I meant to, like, because I said platformer, I mean like a side scroller.
Oh, sure.
The Oculus, like virtual reality is for a first person game.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's shooters and simulators, right? What else can come in first person?
So
how do you play all the other games like
that's a
like
great
an RPG
point.
Or something. Like
well,
that,
they
or...
do have. I mean, it becomes a big giant screen. You're in a living
so
room
you're in
planes.
A living room playing yeah. the game. Yeah, yeah. That's so it caters to a limited genre. Well, I wouldn't say limited. It's a big genre, but it's the amount of games that you can play are limited to first person shooters and simulators like Elite Dangerous.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know. I think once they figure it out, anything in a first person view or the ability to go into a first person view could potentially be in virtual reality, like an MMO. Even an MMO could do it, you know. But
I'm glad you brought that up. But I
guess Smite could, like a well, that's third person. That's related. That's a
yeah.
That's
but
a
anything that
to
can go into Portal would be there. Mm-hmm.
Let's see,
Ziggurat would be there.
Yeah, all first person though.
I mean, those are all very first person shooter likes, anyways. Yeah. But
that's what I'm saying. So I'm just thinking,
dude, it'd be cool to make a Lego game. Virtual reality, and you're
Lego.
A Lego, and you don't see, but it's you're in this Lego world. That'd be cool,
like Minecraft, where you see your hands just.
Yeah. Anyways, great question, great discussion. Thank you. Thank you, G. Engelkins, for asking that. John Matthew wants to know, what is our most anticipated game of 2016? I think The Division is probably universally our most anticipated
on the Xbox
game at this point. Yeah,
probably.
Between now and The Division, Far Cry Primal. I am there. I would just love that trailer. Watch, it's a huge disappointment.
It's awful.
And I'm just buying into this hype.
When Far Cry guys make their like little niche games, they do a really good job.
The little team they got there.
Yeah, they do a good job. Blood Dragon was pretty fun. I felt pretty cool playing that one. So,
Martin Tones wants to know, do you think Rocket League will be on games with gold next month when it launches on Xbox One? And if so, will there be an XoneBros tournament in it?
That would be cool if it was games with gold. I didn't even think of that. I think they launched another game with gold arcade game. What was it?
I don't remember.
No, I'm going to think of it.
Rocket League, when it comes out,
I'm really excited
I think
game.
It will be an XoneBros tournament.
Yeah.
That part I can answer. That game.
I enjoy Rocket League.
Cool. I enjoy watching Rocket League, so I know I'll enjoy playing it.
Meh.
Oh, really?
Really? I'm excited
for
it.
It's soccer
League,
with cars. What more could you ask for?
It's not my thing. It's okay. It's okay. I don't find myself playing that too much. Maybe a couple days.
Have you played it?
No.
No.
I've watched a lot of streamers play it. Mm-hmm. That doesn't count. I mean, it counts, but, you know.
Yeah.
It'll be fun.
There'll be a tournament. There'll for sure be a tournament for it.
I'll play.
Joel Van Egbert says, there's a lot of talk about the Xbox 2 coming out as soon as 2018. Is this too soon? How will we know when it's time? I think that's way too soon. I don't think that's real. That's only 3 years away. Just came out 2 years ago. That's a 5-year lifespan.
Yeah.
When you look, games are just barely beginning to come out. There's just no way that it's worth it. You know, when you talk about research and development and the money that goes into making these things and advertising these things, console turnover will not be that quick.
not at all. Especially, I mean, consoles are getting, the lifespan are getting longer.
Yeah.
I mean, the Xbox 360 is still kind of, it's almost
barely, I would say this year is going to kill it off.
Yeah, yeah, it's, but I mean, that's what, 11 years?
12 almost.
12 years? I mean, we're not even close to.
And if you think about it, as technology improves and internet becomes more available and you're able to offload processes more and more to servers, the lifespan, there's no reason the lifespan wouldn't increase. Unless hardware just jumps forward at insane rates that you can't keep up with and you have to. And I don't think hardware isn't jumping forward that, you know.
It's fast. Plateauing.
Yeah. It's plateauing, yeah. You know, when you look at the Super Nintendo to the N64, that was huge difference. When you look at the N64 to the Xbox 360, that was huge difference. When you look at the 360 to the Xbox One, it's a difference, but it's not as big of a leap, right? Same when you look at the PlayStation or the Nintendo Wii. It's not such a huge leap. It's getting shorter and shorter.
Yeah, so. Yeah.
We're so good.
Yes, we are, David.
We got this all figured out. Andy, thanks, Joel, for that question. Three questions left. Gary L. Porter, how will Xbox stack up against all the new streaming services, i.e. Roku, Kindle, Chromecast, and such? Will Xbox still be a place to stream your Netflix through, your Hulu? What do you think? Will it be able to compete with these $35 devices
that
you can plug in?
Yeah, well, because like I think it will, because I don't buy my Xbox to watch Netflix. If you're going to buy an Xbox, you're going to buy it because you want to play the games, right? So I don't think that's their main concern. But I mean, it's just another place. It's set up in the living room. Yeah. I watch Netflix on it, you know?
Sure.
I'm laying in bed. I watch Netflix on my phone.
Absolutely. You know?
I'm in the bathroom. I still use my phone.
Sure.
I used to use my computer, but now I use my phone. So like it's just whatever device is, you know.
Yeah.
I just think it's just another device to use.
McSpicy.
You're streaming.
Well, I mean, I don't use my Xbox to watch Netflix because it's not. I mean, I have a.
Get a lot of good achievements if you watch Netflix. That's actually why I watch Netflix.
But you don't get any points for it.
Doesn't matter. It's the titles.
You get no achievement score for watching Netflix. You get an achievement, but no achievement score.
You just like the feeling of.
Yeah. You're just like, oh. I just watched 8 shows in a row without stopping.
I mean, you can get for $30. You can get an Amazon Fire Stick that has everything.
Yeah,
you know. So and wherever I don't have a PlayStation or an Xbox, it's those Fire Sticks and my big TV that where me and my wife watch movies on. That doesn't have my Xbox because I like a more personal, smaller TV when I game.
Absolutely.
So I don't think the Xbox. Is going. I mean, most people have multiple monitors or TVs throughout your house. You're not going to have an Xbox for each one of those.
Yeah. So what you're saying is people aren't choosing between an Xbox and a Chromecast or a Kindle Fire.
No.
Yeah.
No.
They have both. Like me, I have all three. Actually, I have the Kindle, the Chromecast, and the Xbox. So yeah. No. Great. I agree. I concur.
We're on fire.
I concur. We are on fire once again. Organic Avenger, going back to our argument on the lifespan of the thing, Organic Avenger brought up a great point in chat. He says the tech isn't changing much, meaning the hardware, right? But the experience they bring is what is changing so much. I think that's a really, really good point. And I think that experience will continue to evolve. Absolutely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So
yeah.
On the same, and that experience can change on the same console, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that happened with the 360. 360 launched. Then Kinect came, changed your experience to a certain extent on the same console.
Maybe not want to get a Kinect. Change that.
Or Guitar Hero Rock Band came out, changed the way that you know how you use an Xbox, how you play the game.
Yeah.
Last but not least, two more questions. Justin Lanham wants to know who would win in a fight. Oh, never mind. I put this on there for fun. Okay, he wants to know who would win a fight, a taco or a grilled cheese sandwich. I say taco all the way.
Or a grilled cheese sandwich?
Taco's got meat. It's got a hard shell.
Well, I mean, it's a sloppy fighter.
Taco is a sloppy fighter, yeah.
But like, I mean,
actually, grilled cheese is pretty dirty itself.
It's been, it's been through heat, man. it's been through the grill.
It's got hot cheese.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't know. See, because the
I'd go.
The toasted cheese is like a clean. He's a trainer. He's worked hard. The taco is just a sloppy. He's like your, I mean, it's
street
two different
fighter.
Styles going in. So it's like Street Fighter. You know, you got your Ken
you got
versus
your professional
your
boxer and your Street Fighter.
Exactly. Blanca, right? Who's the green guy?
I don't know.
Bianca? Blanca? Blanca. He's like this gritty Brazilian fighter, and then you have your Ken, who's martially, you know, he's trained. That's what you're going
classically
against.
Trained.
So you, it could go both ways.
Okay, yeah, I mean, you're all over that. I would agree with you. I bow to your knowledge there.
That was a great question.
That was a great question. Thank you so much, Justin Lanham, for saying that. And last but not least, the one and only Andrew Nolan. He wants to know.
Hey, Andrew.
I know that guy.
Yeah. Fatty Ewok is his gamer tag. Go
love that gamer tag.
Everyone go like him on Xbox. Friend him. Just send him a bunch of requests.
Fatty Ewok.
Fatty Ewok.
F-A-T-T-Y-E-W-O-K.
He is one of the coolest guys ever. Andrew Nolan wants to know, do you feel like Microsoft will leverage premium versions of their apps on Xbox One, much like how individual companies are offering free versus paid version of their apps? Example, YouTube Red. They kind of do it to a certain point with Xbox Live. There's a free version, you know, where you have access to your
basically
basic,
everything except multiplayer.
Multiplayer. And then you have your paid app. So they're kind of already doing that, but I don't know. Do you see them doing anything beyond that?
Well, I mean, let's.
Like, is he talking like the apps themselves?
Will Microsoft like utilize apps? So, for instance, I think they do it also with like no. With Microsoft Music. Is there a free version of Microsoft Music?
I
don't know if there is.
With their own apps, like they're gonna do like a light version type thing.
Correct.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. I don't know.
That I mean, maybe if it becomes more public.
Yeah.
More easier to make apps, but like,
is Microsoft Music the only app that you have to subscribe to that they have?
Subscription. Well, I mean, if you do like Microsoft Fitness.
Oh, that's right.
You can purchase different, you know, trainers to train you.
But don't you get a couple for free, like, to start out?
Yes.
Like, a couple free, you know what
but
I mean?
But the app, like, the app is free.
Yeah.
And then you purchase yoga
trainers,
or whatever it is that you want to train.
So they're kind of already leveraging a premium, just doing it in a by individual product within an app.
Yeah, I don't see them – sorry, I'm away from the mic. I don't see them doing that, like, blatantly, like – like, I don't know, Apple would do it or something like that because you're already paying for the service, you know, Xbox Live.
Yeah. So they're already making money.
Yeah, unless it's like a Microsoft Fitness or Xbox Fitness, I'm sorry, Xbox Fitness where you buy packages within the program,
sure.
Microtransactions.
So in a way, they're already doing it, not quite, you know, I wouldn't maybe say leveraging, like, oh, here's free Pandora, here's paid Pandora, here's free Spotify, here's paid Spotify. They're not really doing it that way. They're more just giving you a platform to purchase products in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyways, great question. Thank you, Andrew Nolan. Remember, Fatty Iwako, like him.
And just
send him a bunch of messages from us.
Yeah.
So
just say hi.
Just spam him.
Send him voice messages.
Yeah.
Anything. Toast. Send him a Scottish message. That would be awesome.
Do it. Hey, by the way, I thought of a great bad guy that had beautiful hair.
Who?
So you ever see Robin Hood?
In the Men in Tights?
No. Not the spoof on on Robin Hood. Oh. The one with Kevin Costner.
Oh, yeah.
The guy from Die Hard. I don't know the actor's name.
Oh, Snape.
Snape. Professor Snape.
Which, by the way, Kylo Ren looks like he could be Professor Snape's son.
He does.
Yeah, like if there was a remake of Harry Potter, they would cast that actor as Snape.
Agreed.
But he was a great bad guy.
He was.
He is a good bad guy.
Wasn't it the King's brother, I believe?
He also was in Die Hard.
I know. One of my favorite Christmas movies of all time.
Great Christmas movie.
It's one of, I love that
really
movie.
Really great Christmas movie.
That's enough, the both of you.
Ouch! Oh, man. This is the portion of the show where we talk about what we've been playing and what we've been up to. Before we get to it, though, our first community play of the year is here. It is Grand Theft Auto 5. It is this Saturday, i.e. tomorrow, January 9th at 9:30 Eastern.
Which means 21 hours from now.
21 hours from right now. Go join everyone. Check out the forums for more details. If you guys want to keep up with the community plays, with everything that's going on, the forums are the place to do it. Head over to xonebros.com/forums. Everyone's there. I hang out there almost every day. So does McSpicy.
I love it there.
I see that you're hanging out there right now via the stream.
I am hanging out there right now via the stream.
Yeah.
Like, what?
I can see your laptop on the stream, and there's the X1Bros logo.
Oh yes. I'm there right now. Anyways, it's the place to go check it out. Go join the community play. Check out the details over at the forums. Thanks, everyone, for for putting up. I think Sheebrew was putting on that community play. I saw him and Toast going to town on Grand Theft Auto. They sent me a couple invites. Sorry, guys, I couldn't join. I was in the middle of kicking some people's butts on Madden. So, i.e. my little brothers. And I'll go first. I played over Christmas break. I got back into ESO again because I'm trying to get to vet status. There's a 16 veteran type, so it's like the it's kind of stupid. I'm not gonna lie. It's kind of pissing me off because it's you reach the end of the game and then you're thinking, oh, I get to go to end game. Before you can get to end game, there's these vet ranks that you have to go through, which they're getting rid of, but they haven't got rid of those yet. So they're a little frustrating, but it's still fun. I mean, I like ESO. I just wish I could get to endgame already. It's a little too grindy for my taste. Yeah. So I got into that. Madden. Played a lot of Madden. Jordan got back into some Madden. My little brother Jonathan purchased Madden. So now, Mark, you can join us. I would encourage you to go check it out.
So I got it now.
So
huh?
you own Madden.
We should do 2v2.
We could do 2v2.
You can do two players on a team.
Do you know how mad down. I get when I play a Madden game? You've seen it. Within 5 minutes.
You can be on David's team.
I go on a walk.
You can be on David's team. And then it'll be me and Jono against you two.
But yeah. I will get mad. That's and a huge. Laugh.
I mean, I could take them both on by myself.
And so. we'll just throw it to the guy Mark's covering.
So here, let me tell you a little bit about Madden. I got into it a lot. I played ranked draft champions. I got in building up my ultimate team some more, some connected franchise. I've been doing a lot of the trainings regularly, jumping on, playing online. I am almost back to where I once was in my glory years.
You're getting that good?
I am. Jordan can play witness to this.
Yeah.
He thinks he's good because he can beat Jonathan, who I play against on almost a nightly basis, right? So, so Jordan's crushing him.
I just beat him.
He crushed.
He
it.
Played for like a week, and then I came back out of retirement and just smashed him.
And smashed Jonathan. which Jonathan and like Jordan have a little bit different relationship than I do with them, in the respect that Jonathan
gets a little upset.
Thinks he's better than Jordan at everything and gets mad if he ever loses. Whereas me, you know, I could just talk trash or, you know, and it's all fun. It's fun in games with them when they play.
When you play Madden.
It's personal.
Like, that Madden, Rejoice Madden Season's Hair campaign for Madden 50, that put it perfectly, because there's a lot of trash talk during Madden. There's things that you would never say to someone that you say during a Madden match.
It is true.
And when I play with David, he just throws it right back at you, right? Like, you know. But when I play with our other brother, he just gets mad.
You can tell he's mad because he'll be talking, be like, "Yeah, I'm doing this play, blah blah blah," and then Jordan will be like, "Oh, I just raped you, man." It's like, you know, and then it's just that's all you hear, and you know. He's
I sent
mad.
Out a mass text you know that mad. Said I spanked him.
Yeah, and he got so mad. Anyways, I am loving Madden. If anyone wants to play in Madden and practice or beat me. Please feel free to do so. I love playing that game. This game, I have gotten more into this game than a Madden game in a very, very long time. So it is everything I'm looking for. Beyond that, did I play anything else? No.
You know what we should play that's a sports game is FIFA. I would play FIFA.
FIFA. If you buy FIFA, Jordan, I will gladly play that game. I like FIFA. You can set up individual tournaments. Very good. I really like FIFA. FIFA.
I would enjoy that game.
FIFA.
I think.
Let's do
I
it.
I think I would.
Let's do it, man.
Okay. Yeah, it's on.
Let's do it. Oh, I also played some Rainbow Six, like I said. I think I'm thinking a little bit.
And
better,
hey, there you go. There's a game Jono can smash me in.
Oh, he can
But I think
smash
he can smash
well.
Half the West Coast in that
yeah,
game.
Yeah, I think he can. Yeah. He's like showing me highlights of his stuff where he is at a window and he pops up, throws a grenade, pops down, goes around. The grenade goes off, and you see he gets like two kills, and then he kicks open the door
like
and gets
breaches
two more.
The other window.
I don't understand it too. If you look at his thread, he has a he just. I think he's lucky too because he's just like randomly shooting from across the map, not even in the building.
He like knows every. Remember when he told you like it's glitched, it doesn't work, and you're just like oh.
No, go look at his thread. He's shooting at a window.
He's like
a boarded up window, and he gets a headshot.
Yeah, well, it's just like in Call of Duty. Like at the beginning of the match, you know where to toss that lucky grenade. You know what I mean? It's like that same. You know
and I'm
where
like
to
wondering
take that.
What you watch it. What is he shooting at? And it's all poom, 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 headshot. And it's like, how did you know a guy was even there?
Yeah, that's hilarious.
If you haven't, by the way, I saw D-Mill said he just got Madden for Christmas. If you guys want, if anyone got Madden for Christmas or has Madden and hasn't jumped in our connected franchise, just join us, XoneBros, and the password is XoneBros. It's a private league. I think we're 19 out of 32, so we still got some spots left. Halo Waypoint, by the way, our Spartan team, completely full.
Yeah, we're maxed.
We have five, I think, on the waiting list. So we'll go through, see who's active, not active, and maybe just make sure that our Spartan team is always active.
Just know that I haven't played for a couple weeks, okay?
Okay.
You can fire me. But okay.
We'll like
give me
out.
A second chance.
Okay. Anyways.
You're not meeting your play quota.
I know. I'm sorry. And I'm a lieutenant in that, right?
For Connected Franchise, this has been a great experience going through this first time. When next season starts, two things. I'm going to clear out anyone who doesn't really play. To freshen it up, and we're going to play more games a week. So you got to be dedicated because it's just taking too long to go through. We're doing two games a week. We're almost to playoffs, but I want to go through, like, I want to do two seasons a month type of deal and really build a dynasty, baby. Yeah. Build a dynasty. Oh, I also played Ark.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ark is a good time. I played with our friend Chris. He has his own server.
Our fellow officer.
Yeah.
And he's got an ARK server.
He has his own server going on. I mean, his own server. He's just doing it on his box. So I'll jump in to see what he's done. He's level 70.
He's hardcore. It's awesome.
He's got pterodactyls flying around there. He's got a huge dinosaur with a freaking RV mode on there.
So I think I played with him before Christmas.
Sure.
Right? Yeah. And he's got a really cool place. Uh-huh. When you log out, your body just goes limp.
Yeah.
He built a castle around me to protect me.
Yeah, he really did. He really did. Because I'm standing there. We played the other night, and I'm like, who's this guy laying on the ground? And it was you.
You're the center point of the castle.
He just drags your body around and moves it. It's so funny. That game, we really want. That game is set up so good for community. The problem right now, I've got this tweet as well, I'm sure you guys have, a couple times. When are we going to get servers? Where are the servers? It's a thread in the forum. What do you guys think? There's two ways we can go about this. We can wait until the servers open up. The problem is when you go on right now, every server is taken. There's like one spot open in each server.
The game's still in alpha, so maybe we should just wait till it launches.
Well, there's no, there's absolutely
because it's too.
Yeah,
because everything's gonna get wiped anyway.
Yeah, I've been looking at like how to. I know the two ways you're gonna talk about. There's no way to get a group into the servers right now. There's just not enough servers. Yeah.
We could just say there's a server, and if you can jump into that server, if you're at home playing at a certain time of day when there's no one on that server, which I don't think even exists.
Like just pick a random server, like server 94.
Just a random server, and if it's 69 out of 70 and one person from XoneBros can get in there, I want to get to where maybe there's like 30 out of 70 or 40 out of 70 so that a lot of guys from our community can go in there and we can just own that server. We can create a cool community. Everybody looks after all the other XoneBros because that is how this game, it would be such a blast to do that.
Yeah, I looked up trying to use a PC to create a server.
Sure.
And it's not possible.
No, I know you can. If you use a separate Xbox.
Yeah, you can use your.
We don't have a separate Xbox. If anyone wants to donate a separate Xbox One to us.
I know that there's. You know, members of the community that have multiple Xboxes for different TVs.
Sure.
Let us know if you wanted, if that's something you're looking
for. That Xbox always has
to be on. You have to leave it on all the time.
And
when the game launches, there's supposed to be, you can host a dedicated server on their side, right? And then obviously that'll always be on.
Yeah.
But that's when the game launches. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm more than happy to rent it. I think that'd be fun, kind of like in Battlefield where you can rent the server. That'd be great. But I think. I don't know. I think it's going to be hard to do community plays until that game is fully released.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Just because there's a lot of stuff going on.
I mean, I could take one for the team and just have my box do that because I could have that. And then I wonder if I can come over here and just eat popcorn and watch you guys.
Well, we can. You can. It's split screen call. It's split screen play. Local.
Is it?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Well, because you're just down the block from me. What if I were to turn it on and then we say community play date?
Problem is, so if you have it on working as a server, can you play other games while it's on?
Like, can I sign in?
Well, maybe you can keep that game in the background. I don't know. We'll have to try it out.
We'll look into it.
Because it won't assign me off on my box.
Yeah, see, Shibu says it's bandwidth too. It just won't. Yeah. I don't know.
I have 1,000 up and 1,000 down. I don't think that's going to be an issue.
You arrogant SOB.
I know. Hey, this is coming from a guy that had terrible internet for his entire life.
And Chibru says he has three that he can dedicate one to try it. Yeah, we can give it a try and see. We'll test it out. We'll see if we can come up with a solution and let everyone know.
For now, just play with who you can. when you can.
If we do one, if we do one, I'm okay with hopping over to your house, Jordan, and playing off of your box, and then we can just set my box up. If we set like a Saturday night or something to do it, I'm okay with doing that. Because you're only a hop, skip, and a jump away from me.
It's true.
You know?
True doctrine. True doctrine. Jordan, what did you play over the break? What was your experience?
I played Madden. Mm-hmm. It was really fun to get back into that, have a couple more wins under the belt. And what else did I play? Oh, I played Fallout.
Good for you.
And I got into the Fable Legends beta.
Did you play that?
I played the tutorial. I've yet to play the multiplayer yet. I'm going to save that for this weekend because I have Monday off of work.
I also got into it. I haven't opened it up yet, though.
Yeah. I feel like there's one more game. Oh, Ark. What? I feel like I played something that I really liked.
Did you play, was it PlayStation?
No. No, I don't know. No, but yeah, but that's what I played. I played Madden. Oh, that was it. ESO. Yeah.
Yeah.
I played ESO and I resubscribed.
He did resubscribe. Yeah. He's back into it and has been sneaking playtime without telling me because I wanted a quest with him, but does he want a quest with me? No. No,
well,
he doesn't.
The thing is it doesn't matter because it takes so freaking long to get to vet.
Well, yeah, what are your thoughts on vet rank?
I think MMOs, you should level up and then you should have end game. I think that's what you should do. How you do that is completely up to you, but I think you should level up to the max level and then immediately that's where you start.
What's making this bearable for me is they have a quest that's specific to this, but since then they've also had an expansion. So Orsinium is really interesting missions right now, and so that's helping buffer the tediousness. I'm thinking about just jumping into World v. World to try it.
Well, it's just like I just really like how Warcraft does it. You level up, an expansion comes out, you level up 10 levels, get the story, and then after that you hit max level and you start grinding for your gear. And the reason I like grinding for gear better is because you can at least see the progress. I mean, you can still see the progress with veteran ranks, you know, oh, I'm veteran rank 2 now instead of 1. But like I prefer gear because like, oh, I'm moving up, but I, you know,
yeah,
it I don't know. One, that you're getting that gear for a goal to do a raid. I just like that formula. I feel like this veteran rank is level up to max level, and then before you can really do end game, level up again, and then actually do it one more time after that, because you go through Cadwell's quest, you know, to get your... I mean, and I know there's other ways to do veteran ranks, but it just feels like... I feel that the veteran ranks, and this is just my opinion, were kind of lazy on their part. They were trying to...
Well, they're getting rid of them.
Yeah, which is great. That reason, I think they are. I think it was just something like, hey, they need more content, just have them run through the other two nations and make it really freaking long and tedious to get to. Because like, I want to... Because you can go to Orsinium at any level, but you are at a disadvantage because it's like in Guild Wars, you're scaled up, but you're not as powerful.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Same thing in Imperial City. I don't know if you're scaled up, but it's still hard to take on those veteran 16 NPCs.
Sure.
You know.
Well, and that's why you go into the veteran worlds and they have the casual and the veteran.
I don't know how it's going to work with champion points too, cuz I mean champion points are better than the well, I guess champion points is their gear, right? Cuz champion points you are leveling up very fast and consistently.
Way you're fast. You're always getting champion
points. And it's giving you that
extra... you're creating a super unique character too. So you can really hone in on like, here's my health skill. I'm a healer, or I'm a DPS, or I'm a tank, or you know.
Yeah, no, but yeah, I did play a lot of ESO and I got to veteran rank 2.
Boom.
So
I'm at half of 1.
Yeah. Cuz what is it? 850,000 experience per veteran rank.
Yeah, so it's insane.
Just forever. So, and I'm almost finished with 2 zones, and they're going up a veteran link every zone, so I don't know, I think they're expecting me to do other stuff while I'm, you know, leveling the veteran ranks, but I just want to finish that, you know?
Absolutely. McSpicy, how about you? You said you didn't play any games. Did you play anything since our last podcast?
Yeah, I played Rainbow Six. I told you at the beginning of the show. Mm-hmm. I jumped in. Oh, I'm excited to play this game.
Sure.
Someone team killed me. Okay, let's play someone else. That guy was a jerk. And they team killed me. So I was like, I'm kind of done with this. I wanted to play Battlefront. I just didn't pull it up. I was going to play Mass. Basically, let's make a long story short. I wanted to play more this week, and I didn't because I had a lot of work going on. And then before this week, I took it kind of easy. Out of town.
Like, I literally did nothing. It was crazy.
Battlefront is a fun game to go to, by the way. If you got nothing to do, just want to play a few rounds.
Yeah, I wish. I have reservations. I wish heroes were a little bit more powerful, and I wish they weren't being spawn, like people crowding the spawn locations of the hero markers. I wish they were random like the original. Mm-hmm. Just give both teams a random player on each team, them appear.
Does the hero token not change where it spawns?
I don't know. I think people have figured out
like where they are.
Yeah. And it's super frustrating. And they're not very strong. So what's the point? And that's why I played Battlefront was because
I think they're strong. Because when I haven't played as Boba Fett yet, but I think Luke and Darth Vader are really. Luke is just fast. So you can traverse the map and just swipe as you're crossing people. Darth Vader's a little bit slower, but he's still. I think the weaker hero. Maybe it's just because I don't know how to use them because they're all way different.
And maybe that.
So,
maybe
but with I have trouble playing with Leia, Han Solo, and the Emperor. I have yet to play as Boba Fett, but I have trouble playing with those three. Because when I get the hero, I just run to people and swipe the sword, and that's why.
Yeah, have you seen the new movie? A lot of people have trouble playing with Leia lately.
But yeah, no, I have trouble with those three heroes, but I mostly always pick Luke or Darth Vader just because of the lightsaber. It's awesome.
And it's a lightsaber.
No. So, anyway.
Yeah, so I didn't play much. I did play, you know, like I said, some PC games.
But, awesome.
But this is an Xbox show.
Awesome. Everyone, don't forget our first community play is tomorrow at 9:30 Eastern, Grand Theft Auto, Organic Avenger, the one and only member of the community. Not the one and only member of the community. The one and only Organic Avenger, a member of the community, is giving us one random player that joins the community play a $15 gift card for Xbox Live.
Yeah.
He will direct message you at some time during the night. So make sure you jump in, you play with the community, and you get to know some bros.
Yes.
And brohemes and brosives. And McSpicy's looking at his X-Wing miniature. If you guys are looking for a good board game and you like sci-fi, we have such a blast with this. Because it's deep and it's it's deep and strategic without being complicated.
It's called Star Wars X-Wing Miniatures Game.
Yes, mm-hmm. And I'm getting into painting them myself. Hashtag nerd level 100.
100?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You're already there. you're max cap. I'm sure you can improve.
I sure am. McSpicy, what will you be up to? Where can people reach you? And what's your gaming goal for this year? Or goal
this
for
year?
The X1 Bros do, for this year? Let's do
this
that.
This year?
This year, 2016.
This is not enough time for me to
New
think
Year's
about
Year's
resolution.
A year goal. New Year's resolution for the X1 Bros / gaming for 2016 as we go out.
A year goal requires, you know,
I'll start with
52
mine.
More than a week goal.
It's your New Year's resolution.
What's my New Year's? I don't do resolutions.
Oh, what?
I do goals like whenever I want. I don't do a new. At New Year's.
I don't confine myself to one one date of the year.
No, I think it's gimmicky. Hey. I think hipster.
You are a hipster all the way, my friend.
No, I just want gonna make a goal, I'm gonna make a goal. I don't like to be told that I have to make a
goal. You don't have to. It's just part of New Year's. It's a chance to start over, man. Start over.
So this is gonna sound stupid and stereotypical, even though I went on that rant.
Sure. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I want to lose weight.
Amen, brother.
I do. Amen. I want to get healthier. So.
Me too. I've got to get rid of these 2 inches that I gained over 1 month. Over 1 month.
Yeah.
Where can people reach you?
Okay. So that's my Xbox year goal is to lose weight.
Lose weight.
You know what? I'm going to do some Xbox fitness. Xbox fitness.
Yes.
And I'm gonna lose. You watch. You people that watch.
Yeah.
The few people that watch the show, I'm gonna get thinner this year.
Very nice.
See? That's my goal, not a New Year's goal.
Maybe I should put you on my website.
What? Like, no. A Costanza shot?
Anyone that follows me on Twitter, I tweeted this out. Starting next week or the week after, the Gamer Strength, gamerstrength.com. If you're into gaming and you like working out, I'm doing it mostly to keep myself accountable.
Oh, okay.
You know, to working out and stuff. Perhaps we'll feature McSpicy and his...
Can I wear a banana thong?
You can wear whatever you want, my friend.
Banana. Let's do a before and after, and I'll wear a banana thong.
Yeah, okay. It's in. Gamer Strength, one of our feature contributors. We'll be McSpicy, gamerstrength.com. Go check it out. It's focused on gaming and working out. Because those two things are, compatible.
They can be compatible. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
They can be also incompatible. So you can find me on Twitter at Mr. McSpicy. My gamer tag is Mr. McSpicy on the Xbox.
Nice. Jordan, nice. How about you?
By the end of this year,
yes.
I want to try and hit 50,000 gamer score.
What is your gamer score right now?
I think it's like 30.
I beat Jordan in the gamer score count for the month of December.
20 points.
Good. So yeah. Good job.
Thank you.
You had five.
What is that app that I'm using?
True Achievements.
Sign up for it. Get on it. It's on Xbox One. It sends you an email every month stating your last month's progress.
I had 510. You had 530.
I had 550.
Oh, then I had 530 because you beat me by like 20 points.
Yeah, so not very much, but I still beat it. It shows you your top played games, your biggest achievements for games. It breaks it down for you. It's great. Love it. If you're an achievement hunter, True Achievements is the way to go. Love that app. So 50,000. Wait, what did you say you're at right now?
I think it's like at, I think it's at 30 something.
So 20,000 in a year. That's pretty good, man, considering you're at 30 over your lifetime.
Yeah.
Oh man!
So
20,000.
Well, no, I worked it out. If I just get 1,000 gamer score per game, that's just 20.
That's
games.
That's platinum.
That's 100%ing a game. That's they're limited.
That's 100%ing.
Well, they used to be
20 games.
I don't know if they're limited anymore.
I think some of them. They either have like.
Or you could 540 games.
They have 1250, or they have.
Have you already gotten the Master Chief Collection?
No, that one has like 4,000.
Okay, I'm going to help you out. The key to making and accomplishing goals is to make smart goals.
Yeah. Well, I think I'm the only one that makes the goals when we do the goals per week.
20,000 gamer score in 1 year.
You think you could?
Oh, yeah. Man. Has anyone in chat gotten 20,000 gamer score in a year? I would just be curious.
Here, let me pull up my
achievement. I know who would have.
Anglophile.
Yeah.
Probably would have.
He did that last week.
If you're at 20,000 or 30,000 right now, that's over your lifetime. That's over two console generations.
I've been slacking lately, though. I haven't really been going for the achievements.
Let's be honest, you probably gamed a little bit more when you weren't married. Yeah. So
no, but
if you're looking to get a divorce, this is probably a great goal to have.
No, I've been slacking on the achievements lately, so I need to get back into that achievement mode.
All right.
Like, I think the last game I bought, I didn't even look at the achievements before I bought it.
Let's do this. Let's to make it softened a little bit, I'll add a goal to this.
Sure.
Any achievement score I get, I'll add to
I'll do it. It's a year.
You'll match anything he hits.
No, so he's at 20, and if he only gets, like, 12,000, we can utilize my bank account of achievements and add that to his score.
I'm going to do it. It's
20?
Yeah. What the heck is my password?
Okay, quick FYI, Jordan has on every, like, whatever he does, Twitter, email, whatever, he has like 15 accounts because he never remembers his passwords on anything.
That's great to do one.
I think you should do like 10,000.
No.
Gamers.
No, I'm going
to
hit 50,000.
Okay, we're going to hold you to it. Everybody out there listening in podcast land, you've heard it.
What do we get to do to you if you don't get that?
I'll buy dinner.
No, I say we create
I'm at 33,566 gamer score.
I say we create a wheel, the wheel of punishment.
That's a great idea.
And we spin it.
There's one section that says nothing, like a little
like Price is Right. And then we get to.
I'm gonna look this up right now if I can get.
And
a
we
wheel
can do it
Amazon.
Live. And you know what I say? We do it. If you don't make it, we invite everyone from the show. Somewhere to someplace, maybe like a ski resort, something.
It will be December.
And everyone that shows up gets to spin that wheel and do to you whatever they spin on that wheel.
This is so good. Okay.
So 33 minus 50. That's 17,000 gamer score. I need to get 17 games. At 1,000 gamer score.
Okay, if you can do that, man, that's impressive.
Look at it's $80 for a 24 tabletop spinning prize wheel.
We're doing it.
Everyone, that looks good too. Look at that. That's so great.
Everyone, if you want to tweet me your ideas for the Wheel of Punishment, you can do so at XoneBros. The Wheel of Punishment next year at this time. We'll see what's going on with Jordan. Anyways, where can people reach you at, Jordan?
Jordan Benix will be everywhere.
What will you be doing this week? You've got to be working towards this 17,000 game. Okay.
So, because think about it, beating a game will get you 500 easy, right?
Not every
four,
game,
four
though.
To five,
no.
Yeah.
Like beating a game, like a Skyrim or a Dragon Age. That
look,
could be, you could be at 300.
I beat
maybe.
Halo 5 and played multiplayer 470, easy.
Yeah, but how many
that's
hours?
Halo, that's kind of a unique game.
And that's your favorite game.
Exactly.
Destiny, I have almost 1,000. Right?
But see, you've already played those. Those don't. That score does not count.
No, because you'll go back and get the achievements that you missed.
Yeah, he could go get achievements that he missed.
I'm not playing like all new games. Like I just
so
want
he just
my
has
gamer
to be
score
at
50,000.
Shebrew says, I don't care what's on the board. I'll make up my own.
We could do that as one of the things.
Yeah,
you choose.
You choose anything you want.
Spinner's choice.
We'll have like, you know, water balloons. I don't know.
I would have more in Forza 6, but someone never got it again.
Oh, yeah. I think I'm down in the count on games. Anyways, my goal for this year, I'm XoneBros. You can find me XoneBros everywhere. Twitter, Instagram. I've been doing Instagram a lot lately. It's a lot of fun. I really enjoy it. And
I saw that you posted,
I like old buildings. I took a picture of the 1928 sign. Yeah,
it's a building.
You couldn't really see the whole building because my camera's not that good. It's just my iPhone, but there you go. Anyways, I am XoneBros. My goal for this year, I would like to stream weekly. Streaming is how I got to know a lot of you guys in the community this past year, or at the beginning, I guess the past 2 years. So I'd like to start streaming more again. That's my goal. It's a little generic, but I'd like to stream and get to know a lot more of you a lot better.
That's a good goal. I want to add that too.
Boom. There you go.
I want to stream more and lose weight.
Stream more and lose. Oh, yeah. Also, I have a weight goal as well, but we're not going to talk about that because I don't want to.
Okay.
Any last words before we get out of here, guys? It's good to be back. I did miss it. I'm going to say the first week it was nice not having to worry about putting together a show or anything because we've been doing it consecutively for 2 years. But the second week I was like, dang, I need to talk games.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no, me too. I like you guys.
I'm excited for 2016.
You know?
Guys.
I'm excited for the community. I'm excited to play a round of golf with Massive Dwarf on Xbox One.
Well,
and I'm excited for next week. See you guys later.